I'd like to call to order Town Board Regular Meeting Number 7 for April 18, 2016. Can I get a roll call?
Councilman Billica?
Here.
Councilman Ronica?
Here.
Councilman Madigan?
Here.
Councilwoman Kenny?
Here.
Supervisor McMurray?
Here. Next, items number 2 and 3, we'll have Matt File from the Whitehaven Road Baptist Church. Is that correct, sir?
Yes, sir.
He will provide us with the invocation, and then we'll have the Pledge of Allegiance led by Mike Madigan. Almighty God, Lord, we thank you so much for this day. Lord, we thank you for the freedoms that you give us in this country, Lord, that reflect the freedoms you give us. God, I thank you for the leadership here. Lord, you tell us in your word to pray for the rulers and the people of authority and the leaders. So God, I lift them all up to you. Please just give them wisdom. Please give them discernment, Lord. Please protect their families, God, because as they're in positions of leadership, there's going to be stresses, Father. So please protect their marriages, protect their family, protect their children, Lord. God, we ask for your wisdom, your discernment, Lord. Give us good judgment tonight so you receive the glory. It's in God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Let the allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. We'll now move to agenda item number 4. If there are any public comments on agenda items only, please move to the microphone and state your name and address. Okay. Move to item number 5. We are now going to have a public hearing on local law intro number 4 of 2016. Term limits. I will read the local law, or proposed local law. So, a local law to set term limits for elected officials. Be it hereby enacted by the Town Board of the Town of Grand Island as follows. Section 1 Amendment of Chapter 70. Chapter 70 of this Town Code is hereby amended to add Article 3 titled Term Limits to read as follows. 70-11, Purpose, Authority. The Town Board of the Town of Grand Island intends to expand participation in the electoral process and to bring new ideas to the governance of the Town of Grand Island. For that purpose, the Town Board adopts this chapter to limit terms of office for certain elected officials in the Town of Grand Island pursuant to New York Municipal Home Rule Law, Section 10.1.2a.i. 70-12, term limits established. No town supervisor of the Town of Grand Island shall serve as town supervisor for more than 2 full terms of 4 years each. No town councilman of the Town of Grand Island shall serve as town councilman more than 2 full terms of 4 years each. 70-13, completed terms, / partial terms, / other elected officials. Terms of office fully completed prior to the effective date of this law shall not count against the maximum term limitations established in this article. That's the relevant part of the law. There's some boilerplate language at the end. With that, we will open the floor to public hearing on local law intro number 4 of 2016. If you have any comments, please move to the microphone, state your name and address.
Dean Maracus, 2196 East River Road. I guess I've got to say that I'm chairman of the Grand Island Republican Committee. However, the following is my opinion only and doesn't reflect the opinion of the committee. There's a lot of reasons for term limits. I am for it. Term limits will bring the diversity of people, keep fresh ideas and perspective in public offices. You have less corruption. John Adams said, without term limits, every man in power becomes a ravenous beast of prey. You know, you think about, you know, nobody likes to talk about corruption, especially with public officials. But you think about the servicemen that are deployed, very, very few of them cheat on their spouses. And I believe the same is true of public officials. Very, very few of them are corrupt. However, having the term limits will decrease the amount of power that people accumulate and decrease the propensity to engage in corrupt activities. You guys passed a trapping law to prevent something that has never happened, you know, which is injury to pets or people, okay? You should apply term limits to prevent possible corruption, even though that probably has never happened. I've never heard of it on Grand Island. There's more opportunities for leadership in the communities. Communities have a tendency to thrive when there are more people involved in the community service. Term limits gives more opportunities to individuals to share their talents and ideas for the betterment of the community, state, or national government. There's more options for voters because every 8 years you've got a fresh crop. There's less opportunity to outlast your usefulness. What this means, it keeps a steady, fresh supply of leaders to serve in elected offices. People become stale after a while in their jobs. And this, you know, you've got three new people on the council. You guys are all excited, engaged. Nothing about the guys that have been here for a while, but still, there is a difference when you first get a new job and you're all excited about it. There's basically two reasons to oppose term limits. One is that there's experience. The notion that only one person incumbent can do a job well is absurd. These aren't my words. Okay, problematically, we continue to elect incumbent because of name recognition and party affiliation rather than proven track record. Realistically, there's usually someone just as qualified to take over the incumbent's office. The Founding Fathers discussed the need for rotation of office. Okay, the other reason is for institutional knowledge, which is the knowledge that you gain while you're on the job. I'm a member of an organization called Professional Ski Instructors of America. We have the members and elect a board of directors. The board of directors elects the executive council. They don't elect a president. When you're elected vice president, it's a 9-year term. 3 years as vice president, 3 years as president, 3 years as past president. And that past president is an honorary board member and a member of the executive team. All of the elected officials are elected based on community service. And we've got hundreds of people between all the advisory boards, political committees, the organizations like, you know, Rotary, Lions, Elk, VFW, that do community service. And what I think is that we should establish an advisory committee of past elected officials. In this way, we preserve, make it a required 4-year term, no pay. You're just a past elected official, and you're a volunteer passing on your intellectual or institutional knowledge to people that are going along. Thank you.
Just for the record, we have not passed any traffic law yet. Just okay. For the record.
Thank you. Hank Cushing, 216 Timberlake Drive. I support the term limit law as well. I believe that if a person is so toned to want to provide their inputs to the community, there are several avenues, many avenues, in which they can, once they've completed their terms of limit. There's no reason why an ex-official cannot come to meetings, cannot provide his input, and everything is given that opportunity, and I think that that's the best way for us to have new ideas and to breed new grounds. Thank you.
Hey, sir. Hank, just real quick, quick question for you. How about in terms of, so it doesn't say consecutive, what if they took one term off and then maybe ran for election again for 2 or 4 years later? What would your opinion be on that?
I still believe they should only have 2 terms.
Total terms, okay. Because that's how it reads currently.
Paul Cotman, 246 Timberlake. I also support the term limits. And you stole my thunder, Mike, because that was my question. Whether it would be consecutive terms. And I do think that, you know, the council and the supervisor, there are many, many, as this gentleman indicated, many, many opportunities to serve the community of Grand Island. New council was just, instated of community members to work on things the supervisor perhaps, would envision for the future of Grand Island. So, and all the meetings are open, and certainly input from ex-county officials is, I'm sure, welcome, especially with all their expertise, so I certainly support this. And my question was, if someone served a 4 or 6 year term, and it wasn't consecutive, some other time, they could serve another term. I guess that would be okay. But if it's consecutive and you're done, you're done.
The way it reads is, again, shall serve as town supervisor or councilman for more than 2 full terms. So you could get 8 years as supervisor, 8 years as councilman. So 16 total.
I think what he's asking is saying, say you were in office for 4, 6, 8 years, you decide to come back and rerun.
There's no safe harbor or cure period in the law, as Mike said earlier.
And what's your feeling on that? Like, if someone ran 8 years consecutive and then maybe 5 years or 6 or 8 years later wanted to run again?
I think the term limits as they're set is more than enough, Mike. And if someone wants to continue to serve in a capacity, it doesn't have to be as a supervisor or the town board. There are liaison positions, there are any kind of number of positions on just about any board in Grand Island that would come to someone's expertise, whether it be conservation, planning, finance, whatever. So I think if you want to continue to serve, there's a place for you. So that's my.
Do you have a supervisor advisory board meetings open to the public?
Yeah.
Are they published somewhere?
We can publish them. Have we not published them?
Yes, the advisory board minutes are published on the website.
Yeah.
Advisory are, but what was your question?
Supervisor advisory board.
Thank you for your time.
Yeah, it is open. So those are posted.
I've just got a quick question.
Sure, come on.
So let's say somebody serves 4 years as councilman or supervisor, and then takes 4 years off. Their job gets busy, they have kids, whatever, and then they want to come back. They can come back for another 4 years.
Yes, they can. Or actually another 12 years. If they only serve, let's say for example, I quit after 4, I don't run again. I can take 20 years off and come back, run for 4 more as supervisor, and then also run for town council.
Right.
So yeah. Or town clerk. Or town justice.
Where there are term limits.
And that's not foreshadowing, I'm just saying there's possibilities of those.
Right.
All right. Okay, are we, is the floor closed now? Are we closed, everyone? Any other comments out there? Okay. So, item number 6, I'll enter.
Hold on, I saw a hand come up.
Oh, sure. Is it
I'm sorry to be so late in that.
No problem.
I was thinking about the circumstances where one of the members of the town councilman moves, and you have a 3-year term left over. You appoint someone to fill that term, so that's 3 years. That's not a full term. They can still run for 2 consecutive.
Correct.
Yes.
That's
yeah. It says full.
So process. Theoretically, you could have someone run longer under a certain set of circumstances. Right?
Yes.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I think the way it works is you appoint somebody, and they're appointed until the next November, where they'll have a special election.
Right.
And at that point, they're elected for the rest of the term, be it 2, 3 years, mm-hmm. and then they're back on their regular 4-year cycle again.
That's right. Okay, thanks for all of your input. And by the way, I appreciate those who come steadily to these meetings. It makes the meetings a lot more colorful and interesting. And thank you for your comments. I especially like the quote, ravenous beasts of prey.
I like that.
So, especially with all we're talking about lately. So, so section 6 of item 6, I will entertain a motion to accept the past minutes from the workshop meetings. Number 6.
No, we're not. Wait, it's just a public hearing.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Refer to the board. Refer to the board. I'll entertain a motion to refer that law to the board.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Madigan?
Aye.
Billica?
Aye.
Veronica?
Aye.
Kenny?
Aye.
McMurray?
Aye. So item number 6, I will entertain a motion to accept the past minutes from workshop meetings number 16, 17, 18, and 19, and also from regular meeting number 6.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Kenny?
Aye.
Billica?
Aye.
Veronica?
Aye.
Madigan?
Aye.
Aye. Item number 7, consent agenda. We receive the following. Meeting minutes from the Traffic Safety Advisory Board from March 25th and April 12th. Building permits that were issued in March. Meeting minutes from the Zoning Board of Appeals from March 3rd. Facility and vehicle usage reports from the Golden Aid Center for March. Meeting minutes from the Planning Board from February 8th. We also received flyers about 3 very interesting and important events that are coming up. A flyer for National Prescription Drug Take-Back Day, April 30th at 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Town Hall. And did you know there's a website called smart911.com where you can fill out pertinent information that will be stored, so if you ever need to call 911, it comes up automatically, and the basic information is there for you. You can go to smart911.com. It only takes a few minutes to register. If you have any small children, the Erie County Sheriff's Department is offering a car seat check at Town Hall in the parking lot on May 7th from 9 a.m. to noon. Make sure those car seats are installed properly, which is always hard, especially when you want to get one car seat out of one car and put it in another car. It's always a big to-do. Are there any communications with the town board for the consent agenda? Okay, moving to item number 8.
Motion to accept the consent agenda.
Okay, I will entertain a motion to accept the consent agenda.
So moved.
Second. Whichever.
Roll call.
Zilliqa.
Aye.
Kenny.
Aye.
Veronica.
Aye.
Madigan.
Aye.
McMurray.
Aye. The supervisor section. So I have the monthly supervisor report from March 2016. The highlights are we have a total cash balance, including operating and investments, of just over $11 million. We have total receipts of just over $1 million. And total disbursements of just over $1 million. The operating account balance is at just over $4.5 million. The investment balance is at just under $11 million. Our total cash balance is shy of $15.5 million. Please note this is received and filed. Item 9, communications from the town attorney. Peter, do we need to set a public hearing for the amendment to the sign code?
Yeah.
Can you read it for us?
Sure. We don't have to read the whole amendment, but essentially when the town code was recodified a couple of years ago, it appears that the publishers left out something that was had been previously law that the board didn't intend to eliminate. So there's been a correction made to correct that. So it's intended to be consistent with the prior.
Second.
Roll call.
Veronica.
Aye.
Zilliqa.
Aye.
Madigan.
Aye.
Kenny.
Aye.
McMurray.
Aye. May 2nd. May 2nd.
Thank you.
So communications from John Whitney, item number 10, in engineering and water resources. We need to approve awarding Grand Island Waste Management a contract to provide pumping and hauling of liquid sludge at the rate of 0.045 a gallon, pending engineering and legal review. I'll entertain a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Veronica.
Aye.
Kenny.
Aye.
Zilliqa.
Aye.
Madigan.
Aye.
Aye.
And just as a note for that one, if that's okay, there's a fairly good savings on that, about 4% reduction. John Whitney was managing that, so good job.
Well said. Second one, in the section 10. After multiple coats, it is recommended the town purchase topsoil from Leo Brennan Topsoil at $8.95 a yard and use Venturi Concrete at $7.75 a square foot for flat work concrete repairs, $30 a linear foot for dish curbs, and $25 a linear foot for upright curb. I'll entertain a motion.
So move.
Is there any
discussion? So can we just have a
discussion? Sure, we can have a discussion after you make a second.
Okay. Second.
Second. Discussion?
So quick discussion in referring to Peter. Are we able to pass the motion based on the belief that there's been multiple, which we think there are, quotes received?
Yeah,
if we found out that there were not, could we then retract that and just request a new bidding process so there are multiple quotes?
Sure, you could adopt it as follows. You could simply say motion to approve subject to confirmation that multiple quotes have been obtained and that the procurement is consistent with the town's procurement policies.
Okay. So what's the process for
so it would be you could ask, I'm not sure who made the motion.
I'll amend the motion. So I'll make the motion that we approve, provided that this quote was obtained after receiving multiple quotes from other vendors.
In accordance with the town's procurement policy.
In accordance with the town's procurement policy.
You'd ask whoever made the motion and seconded it intend to consent to that.
You consent to that? I think, Ray, you made it?
Yes.
Who seconded it?
I consent.
Okay, so we got, so roll call then?
Billica?
Aye.
Madigan?
Aye.
Veronica?
Aye.
Kinney?
Aye.
Item 11, communications from Joel Mentor in record. Yes, sir.
We need to award the...
Oh, which one?
Wastewater.
I thought we did that already. We already have the motion to award the...
Award the Topsoil or Cagri.
We didn't do the liquid sludge?
Yeah, no, we did that first.
We did that first.
No, no, water's too wastewater, repair material.
Oh.
The bed sheet is various types of materials that they buy from various vendors.
Okay, let me see. How did I miss that?
It's the last sentence on the sheet. Water wastewater repair materials should be purchased from the supplier with the lowest price for the desired item. Make a motion to that effect.
Are you making that motion?
Yes.
Second. Discussion?
Subject to the same contingencies in the first motion.
Subject to the same contingencies in the first motion, I think that's fair.
Oh, we have that, Peter, because there's a sheet of paper attached to this.
It says it on.
That has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 vendors on it.
Yeah.
That's covered in the cheapest price.
So is there any further discussion on this item? So then we'll have roll call.
Billica?
Aye.
Veronica?
Aye.
Madigan?
Aye.
Kinney?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you. So we'll move on to item 11, communications from Joe Mentor in Recreation. Permission to transfer Sharon Ziffran from part-time status to seasonal status for a period of 5 months, after which she will return to part-time status as requested. Effective date, April 19, 2016. I'll entertain a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion? Roll call.
Veronica?
Aye.
Billica?
Aye.
Madigan?
Aye.
Item 12, communications from Tom Dworak in the Parks and Maintenance Department. Tom needs us to approve a summer hire, Philip Stellar, at $9.25 an hour, starting on May 9th. I will entertain a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion? Roll call.
Madigan?
Aye.
Kinney?
Aye.
Billica?
Aye.
Veronica?
Aye.
Item 13, communications from Judy Tafalski in the Assessment Office. Judy wants to add an additional day of grievance just in case there is high volume. She's requesting Thursday, May 26th. I support this. I'll entertain a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion?
Can I just ask a question?
Sure, go ahead.
Does that mean that people can still go in and get an appointment for this particular, if they have a grievance?
Yes.
So they're extending the grievance.
So this is the review board. This is step two.
This is official grievance.
Because there's a high volume, therefore she wants to make sure there's enough space. Okay.
But you know what? Doing this is almost, is similar to the first step, so. So I mean, it's good.
Okay, so can we entertain, we have a motion maybe?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any further discussion? Roll call. Roll call.
Billica?
Aye.
Veronica?
Aye.
Madigan?
Aye.
So planning board info, item number 14. So we did some of this downstairs regarding the seekers, but we have some work to do on Gun Creek. So I'll start. They have requested that we set a public hearing for the next board meeting, May 2nd, on the pending request for the detailed plan slash final plat approval for phase 1B of the Gun Creek subdivision, as required by the PDD review process set forth in the zoning code. I'll entertain a motion to set the public hearing for May 2nd.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Billica?
Aye.
Veronica?
Aye.
Madigan?
Aye.
Kinney?
Aye.
McMurray?
Aye. I also want to entertain a motion to approve local law number 3 of 2016 regarding amending the development concept plan for Gun Creek Plan Development District.
Are we skipping?
Are we skipping which one?
Well, yeah. We need to do a bunch more under the planning board.
Sure. Yeah, the Hugel Storage, River Oaks. I'm sorry, I just wanted to do the Gun Creek stuff all together. I'll come back. I'm sorry.
Right.
Are we okay to do this approval of local law number 3 of 2016?
Yes. Yeah, the only notation to make, it's my understanding that the engineering department requested some minor modifications to the concept plan, and there was a revised concept plan that was submitted by Council Blue Developer on April 11th. I think it's just a minor modification.
It's actually today.
Yeah.
The plan dated April 11th.
Plan dated April 11th, submitted today.
Yeah, I didn't want to change the date because it was already referenced in the draft.
So it's consistent with the plan as previously drawn with some minor adjustments on some backyard setbacks against the green space, as I understand it, as was requested by the engineering department.
So what actually required by us?
So if it's acceptable to the board, you would adopt it as local law number four.
Three.
2016.
Is that acceptable to the board? Will I entertain a motion to adopt local law number three, 2016, consistent with the plan as previously proposed?
As amended.
And as amended?
As amended.
Exactly.
Roll call.
Veronica.
Aye.
Philica.
Aye.
Nattigan.
Aye.
Kinney.
Aye.
McMurray.
Aye. All right, and we should be noted that that plan, as we spoke about previously, is significantly lower density than was first conceived, and they're doing, they seem to be doing their best to try to fit in with that neighborhood. Okay. Hugel Storage, okay, I'm going to ask for the following motions. Hugel Storage, 276 Bedell Road, Phase 8 revised three structures. We are doing a approval of the correct word.
Site plan.
Site plan approval. I'll entertain a motion.
So moved. Second.
Roll call.
Kinney.
Aye.
Veronica.
Aye.
Philica.
Aye.
Nattigan.
Aye.
McMurray.
Aye. The next is the River Oaks Marina, 101 Whitehaven Road, wholesale, says office building and storage building. I'll entertain a motion for the approval of this plan, subject to the following. One, waiver of the parking requirement. Two, a requirement that they plant trees that are at least 5 feet tall as part of Phase 1 landscaping. Three, a requirement that the footprint of the building that's actually built fits in within the footprint of the building that's set out on the plan. And four, that the developer communicates with the town board regarding the progress towards fulfilling parking requirements or updating parking requirements over the course of the next 2 years to be completed within 2 years.
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion? We go, okay. Roll call.
Nattigan.
Aye.
Philica.
Aye.
Veronica.
Aye.
Kinney.
Aye.
McMurray.
Aye. Number three, approval of the plan for Pinto Equipment, 2409 Whitehaven Road, 10,000 square foot building. I'll entertain a motion. Roll call.
Veronica.
Aye.
Philica.
Aye.
Nattigan.
Aye.
Kinney.
Aye.
McMurray.
Aye. Number four, approval for the site plan for Island Kids Daycare, 1353 Ransom Road, building expansion. I'll entertain a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Nattigan.
Aye.
Veronica.
Aye.
Philica.
Aye.
Kinney.
Aye.
McMurray.
Aye. I think that takes care of all the planning board info. So I'll move on to item 15. Mike, can you give us a report of the audit committee?
I'd like to make a motion to pay the following amounts from the following accounts. The general fund, $42,491.94. The highway fund, $7,603.31. Sewer fund, $9,088.42. The water fund, $9,644.74. The capital fund, $8,475. The lighting district for $70. The refuse and garbage fund for $116,128. The capital reserve for $826.52, for a total of $194,327.93.
Okay. Thank you, Mike. Oh, perhaps get a second.
Sure.
I second.
Oh, you did, yeah.
I second.
This motion. Any discussion? Roll call.
Nattigan.
Aye.
Kinney.
Aye.
Philica.
Aye.
Veronica.
Aye.
McMurray.
Aye. Are there any additional, number 16, actually, the unfinished business we already covered, so number, item 17, are there any additional comments from the public today? Any other comments? Okay. Item 18, are there any comments from the board?
I have one.
Yes, sir.
One thing to be aware of is just over the next several weeks through the 17th of May, the schools will be developing their budget, as well as, I believe there are two board positions that are being elected. So be aware of that, May 17th. It was reported in the newspaper, I don't know how factual this is, I haven't actually seen the actual numbers, I saw some of the earlier numbers, but they're reporting that it'll be about a 5.1% increase in taxes for the school board. So just to be aware and, you know, educate yourself on what that's about, what's driving that, and do vote on May 17th.
Yeah, Mike, I was looking at the budget yesterday. It's a 5.01 increase in the budget, but a 3.4% increase in the levy.
So, okay, so that's actually the increase in the taxes would be 3.4.
61 million, they should be approving it tonight.
Or is it?
Yeah, the total budget, total budget's about 61 million and the levy is 31 million.
Okay.
Okay, also I'd like to add, tomorrow is election day, so encourage everyone to go out and vote. Even if you don't like the choices, there's gotta be one you like better than the others. So
that's a good point, I forgot about that.
Yeah.
That's why it's so empty in here. It must be either seeing Bill Clinton or Trump tonight. Huh?
Okay. So I'll take a motion as an order to adjourn tonight's meeting at, how is it exactly? 8:39. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Aye.
Carried. Please rise. Tonight we'll observe a moment of silence in memory of Virginia Matthews, Robert Falcone, Donald Wiant, Donna Goss, Ronald Venturini.
Meeting adjourned.